Hello kids, welcome to yellow class stone painting session with Nidhi ma'am. Over to you Nidhi ma'am.
Yeah, thank you Nikita. Hello kids, good evening everyone. So we are again together to make new painting, okay? So today we are going to make stone painting, people painting, whatever you call it, okay? So all are excited, happy? Very good, very good. So we'll just wait for a minute or two so that all the children come in, and then soon we will start within a minute. So just get ready with all the materials required till then, and within a minute we will start our work, okay? So all my children are rest, so ready, very good. So happy, na, you all? Wonderful, wonderful. That's wonderful. So kids, what material you are having? I'll just show. See, we need people, stones. Preferably if they are round, it's more perfect. If they are not round, then also fine. Just don't worry. Then we will need acrylic colors, brushes, thin and thick. That's right. And water so that we can wash our brush, and a rough kerchief so that we can clean. Yeah, that's nice. Okay, so children, I would suggest that if you have acrylic color, yeah, go for it. Okay, but in case you're not having acrylic color, then only go for watercolor. Okay, but if you take watercolor, please don't put too much of water, because then you won't be able to complete your painting. The color, watercolor, dries very slowly, beta. So that's why I have told to take acrylic color. The acrylic color dries very fast. So that's why we are preferring acrylic colors on stone painting. So in case, worst, if you are not having, yeah, perfect. If you are not having acrylic color, then only go for watercolor, but that too with very little water. The color should be little thicker side, okay? So that you can make a nice one. Very good. So children, let's start with the material part. Let's see what material we will need. And then we will, yeah. So see, these are the paintings, this type of paintings we are going to make, okay? So this is scenery, this is flower painting, this is one insect, this is bee, and this is car. So we'll go one by one. Let's see how many we can make. So I'll just put this aside and show you. See how I'm having the... See, I'm having this type of stones. So can you see these are little bit of round and flat. See, if you get flat, now it becomes easy to do color also, and it becomes easy to make something on it, okay? If it is too up and down, then you won't be able to make the drawing properly. So just prefer the flat one. If you're having 4-5, just take the one which is more flat, okay? Little big and flat, okay? Yeah, and then I have taken acrylic colors. See, all the colors are acrylic, okay? So get the acrylic color ready with yourself, okay? And now I am having brushes. See, this is all different kinds of brushes, but you, more you need is one thick and one thin brush. Two are sufficient. One thick brush and one thin brush, okay? Good, good, good. I can see all of you are having so beautiful, wonderful, wonderful, okay? So these two brushes are necessary for our painting, okay? Then one or two earbuds. Can you see earbuds? Yes. These are the earbuds. One or two, we will be needing it, okay? And a glass of water so that if we want to wash our brush, we can wash it, okay? And a rough kerchief so that we can dry our brush whenever needed, okay? So I hope children, you all are ready with the material. Today we don't need too much of material, okay? So nice, so nice. So just get ready with your stone. First stone. First we will make it, we will be making this painting. Okay. This is the painting we are going to make first. So just take a flat stone. Okay. So just take the bigger stone, whatever, whichever you have, na, that just take the biggest stone you have. And with a flat surface. Okay, dear? Okay, okay. So I can see everyone is ready with the material and all are so excited. Okay. So till everyone is getting ready, I'll just give a fast recap of the material. See, I have taken the stone. All these fabric colors, acrylic colors, and one thick and thin brush. 2-3 birds, earbuds, and a glass of water. Okay. So I hope now the material part is clear, dear. So just get ready. We will be making this first painting. So just get ready with the bigger stone. The bigger you have, take that one. Okay, so now just take a red color and black color and yellow. So three colors we are going to take. Okay, red, yellow and black. So this is the painting we are going to make with red, yellow and black. Okay, so I'm starting with the red one. Just open the red color. And take the thick brush, dear. Because first we will be making the base. So just take the thick brush and get the red color ready. Because if you take black color, na, then the red color becomes blackish. That's why we are taking red color first. If we do red color first and then we take black color, then our red color remains intact. Okay. So that is the reason we are going for red color first. So we don't want to mess up with the red color. Okay. So see, more than half, 2/3 part we will be making with red color. So just take your, dip your brush. Please children, I repeat, if you are taking watercolor, the color should be thick. And those who are having acrylic color, just go for it without water. Okay. I would suggest not to add water in any color. So just dip your color in red, brush in your red and make a straight line like this. So we get a line above which we have to do the color. Now on the top portion, we will do the red color. Okay. So just with the help of your brush and color, the upper part is to be done by red. So just look at this. I'm just putting this aside so that you can see properly. Okay. So just do the red color. Be very careful. The color should dry fast. That's why I'm telling you to take thick color. Okay. If the color is very, very runny, then you won't be able to do it nicely. Once you paint this stone, na, you very good. Once you paint this stone, you can use it as like a paperweight also. You can use it on the table. You can decorate it also. Very good, very good. I can see many of those. Just what you do, once the coating is little dried up, just give a second coat on the red color. So where we get a very beautiful color. Otherwise, what now? The stone will be... We can see the stone from the color. Okay. So we want a little thick coating. So once when you feel the coating is dried up a little bit, just give a second hand on the coating so that the stone hides fully beyond the color. We don't want the stones to be seen from the color. Okay. I hope, children, you all are clear. Very good, very good. Okay. So now what I'm doing, see, the red color is on 2/3 part. Okay. And now we will be taking black color. So now when we will take black color, na, our red color will remain intact because we have already done the red color. So now just take the black color and with very, very careful hand, do on the remaining part of the stone. I'll just show. Just look at me carefully. Be very careful while making the line. This should be also coated twice so that we get a good black color, okay? Just do it very, very, very nicely so that the painting becomes beautiful. We want wonderful painting at the end of the session. So just do it with very careful hands, okay? There should not be any gap between red and black color. They should touch each other properly, okay? With a line. Yes. So just dry them. Very good. Very good. I can see all are doing so nicely. Very good, beta. Wonderful job. Because when we do the other color, now we want, yes, this color to dry up. That's why we are taking acrylic color, okay? That is the main. The acrylic colors have beautiful shining. So these two are the reasons we are taking acrylic color, okay? So see, now both the colors, we have done it properly, okay? So now I'm just putting this thick brush aside. Now we will be taking thin brush. So just go for the thin brush. Now I'll just show you, we will be making this tree now, okay? So just take the thin brush. The thinnest brush you have, go for that. Yes. So just get ready with the thinnest brush you have, dear. Very good. I can see everyone is getting ready with the thinnest brush. Beautiful, beautiful. Okay. So we will continue with the black color now. And with the thin brush. Okay. So what we will do, we will make a line here a little bit slanting. We will not make a straight line. See, generally, na, when we go to some seashore, generally the coconut trees, they are little bit slanting. The trunks are little bit slanting always. If you watch, na, whenever you go on seashore, the coconut trees are little bit slanting. Okay. So we want to give a good look. So what we will do, we will make a slanting line with the thin brush. Take very less color in your brush. Don't take too much. And make a slanting little bit, not too much, okay? Just make a slanting line like this. And make it little thick, not too thick. Because coconut tree don't have too thick trunk, okay? So we need little thick tree or trunk, that's all. So I made this slanting trunk on the down part of the, on the, this, from red and black, wherever they are mixing, na, from there. Okay. So I hope you all can do it. Good, good, good. Perfect, perfect. That's beautiful. Now you know what we will be making. Now the leaves, okay. So we will be making like this. Just look at me with very thin brush and less color. Just make line like this. 4-5 is enough, not more than that we need, okay? So just make thin branches, because we will be making still more work on that branches. So try to make thin. That's why we are taking very thin brush here. That is the reason. So take very less color. If you take more color, it will spread on the painting and you won't get a beautiful effect, okay? So we want a delicate effect. That's why we are taking very less color. That is the main thing. And now we will be giving little shape of the coconut tree. So how we will just make lines like this. Can you see it? Once you make this painting, you can use this as a paperweight on your table. They look beautiful, dear. They give a wonderful effect. They are very good decorative piece on your table. So like this, we will make all the leaves of our coconut tree. So our tree is ready. Can you see? I hope, children, it is not difficult. Just do with the thin brush. Then you can do it. That's why just don't take thick brush, because thick brush will be taking more color and it will be difficult for you to do the tree. So just take the thin brush and you can do it, okay? Now just wash your thin brush once you have finished the tree, because we want our brush to be very clean. We will be making sun now. So just make the brush clean, because if the brush is black, then our sun will be blackish in color. So we don't want that, okay? So now just take the yellow color. And make a small round here. Don't make too big circle. Half circle we have to make. Like this. Okay? Because we are showing that the sun is going inside the sea. Half is gone and half is going. We are making the scenery of sunset. That's why. So we have to show only half sun. So make it only half circle, okay? So half circle is ready, okay? So once you finish this half circle, then we will give the shade of the sun which is going inside the sea. Little bit shading we want to give, okay? So what we will do, we will take little bit of yellow color and we will do little bit with very light hands like this. With very light hands. We don't want proper yellow in the black portion, because we want to show the sun has gone inside and we can see the shadow of sun in the sea. So we don't want to show the perfect yellow color. We just want to show the shade, and that is the reason we are giving it little lighter color. So you just look at this. Okay. So just you have to give little bit shading in the black portion. So half the sun has gone inside and half is showing up. That is the aim we want to make this. Okay. Now what we will do, we will take little bit of yellow color and we will show in this portion, because sometimes when the sun sets, we see this orange color in the sky also. So just with little hands, just give a line or two in the red portion, okay? Just a few randomly. So now our this sunset scenery is ready. So I hope, children, you all are done. Very good, very good. Just do it slowly, slowly, no hurry. Just make the half circle with sun, then give little bit shading down the in the, very good, very good. Just give little shading in the black part and a few strand of yellow color in the sky. Because when the sun sets, we see yellow color in the sky, na? Orange or yellow, that's why. So now our painting sunset. Now it's looking so beautiful. So can you see the tree? Here is the sky and like this. So this is the time of sunset. Good, good, beautiful. Wonderful. I can see the children have beautiful job. That's looking so wonderful. Good job. Good job. So children are doing so well. Wonderful. Okay. So those who have done, just get ready with another big stone. Okay. We will be making flowers with our color on the stone. So those who have finished, just get ready with one big stone with flat surface. Yes, good one, good one. That's nice, good, good, good. Okay, so I hope you all have done till here. So the sunset scenery is ready for everyone. Good, good. So just show me so that I can know you all have done. Wonderful, wonderful. Good job. That's so beautiful. Oh, my children are so smart. That's very nice. You all have become so smart. Very good. Wonderful job, dear. Okay, so let's go for the second one. So now I'm putting this aside and I'm taking the second one, okay? We will be making bunch of flowers on this. Okay, so now I'm putting these two colors and I'm taking sky blue color. You can take any light color. You can take light yellow, light orange, light blue, any light color. Okay, light pink. I'm taking blue color, but I will tell you, you can take any light color, whichever you love. Light yellow is fine, light pink is fine, light orange is fine. But the color should be light so that your flowers will look beautiful. Okay. So just get ready with the stone and a light color. See, I'm taking the sky blue color. So are you all ready with the stone? Shall I proceed? Okay, so again I'm taking a thick brush. So if your brush is not clean, just clean it up, because this time we are taking light color. So if you take the same brush of red or black, your color will be all messed up. So just wash your brush very nicely, dry it very nicely, because this time we are going for a light color. Okay. So now let's start with the light color. We will cover this full stone with the blue color. Yes, just do it like this. Just give a beautiful coating on the full stone. We don't want to see the base or in the stone part in the color. Okay. We want to see the color part only. So just do it nicely. If you feel the stone is looking from the downside, just do it second time. Coat it. Give a second coat with the color. Take thick brush so that you can do it fast also, okay? Don't take thin brush while making the base. If you feel like that the color is thin, just give a second coat. This is just, we are doing a blue color to make the base on the stone. I repeat, dear, you can take any color, light yellow, light pink, light orange, no problem. Okay. Because light shade will give a beautiful effect when you make the flowers. Those who are using watercolor, please be careful to use thick color so that when you make the flowers, your color don't spread, okay? So now, can you see I have done full blue color and we cannot see the stone from the downside. We don't want to see the stone in the background. So that's why I have done full red blue color properly. So just get ready. Very good. Very good. That's good. Everyone just get ready with the base of the stone. Very good. Very good, dear. I can see many of you have completed the color. Okay. Wonderful job. Okay. So once you get ready, now we will go for the flower part. Okay. So you have to take the dark color. See, I am taking pink color. Okay. So you can take pink on this. Even orange looks nice. So we will be taking, I'm taking two colors, pink and orange. So if you have taken blue color, you can take pink, orange. Even you can take purple also. That's why we took light color in the base, okay? So just take orange and pink color. Both the color looks nice on any light color. Okay? And take one earbud in your hand. One earbud. Okay, we'll be making flowers with this earbud. So just take your earbud. First, we will make few flowers with one color. So don't dip your earbud in both the colors, otherwise your flowers will not look beautiful. So first, we will make few flowers with one color. Then we will take another earbud and we'll make flowers with another color, okay? So just go for one color, whichever color you are taking, just take it one color at a time. Okay, I'm taking orange color first. So I'll be making 2-3 flowers with the orange color. Okay, so dip your earbud in the color very little. We want very little color in the earbud. Be careful. If you take more color, it will spread and your flower will become too big. We want small flowers, okay? So just dip your this and make 5 drops like this. Just make 5 drops like this. See, we will be making flowers on the upper part. Downside, we will make green leaves type of thing, okay? So just make flowers on the upper part of the stone. So don't dip your earbud too much in the color. Take little color. and don't press your bud too much. If you will press it too much, the flower will become too big. We want small, small flowers because our stones are not so big, na? So we want to give a delicate effect. Okay. So if you do slowly, slowly and with light hands, you'll be making small, small flowers. So just make 4-5 flowers. If your stone is small, you can go for 2-3 also, no problem. So now I am done with the orange color. So I have kept that earbud aside, okay? Now I'm taking another earbud with pink color. Don't mix your earbud with both the colors, otherwise your color will be mixed with each other and you won't get a beautiful effect, okay? So now I'm taking the second color and do the same process and make few flowers with another color. If you put 4-5 drops, you'll get the shape of flower, okay? You don't have to put more drops. Just put your earbud 4-5 times and you get a beautiful flower. If you wish, you can make flowers of one color also, dear. Okay, so there is no hard and fast rule that you should make flowers of two colors only. This is just for beautification. When we make two color flowers, the painting looks more beautiful. That's the only thing. But if your stone is little small and you want to make flower of one color, that is also perfectly fine. No worries about that, okay? Now what we will do, we'll just put a drop with one more earbud in between the flower with black color. Just take a little black color and put a small dot in your flowers. So our flowers are all ready. So I hope the making flowers with the earbud is not difficult for you all, okay? Yeah, it's fun, na? Good. I can see very good. All children are taking so much of efforts to make beautiful painting. Good job, dear. That's beautiful. Wonderful it is looking. Yes, very good. That's very nice, bachas. Okay, so now once you are ready with the flower part, very good. Now take the thin brush and get ready with the green color. Okay, now just take green color, whichever green color you have is okay, no problem at all. All the green colors are fine. Light, dark, any color green is fine. And make standing line sort of below each of the flower, like this. just make sending line between these flowers. Okay, so we are making the branches and then we will give little bit shade of leaves. So just give with, just take very less color in the brush. Be careful with the color part. See, the stone is very small, so you have to be very careful while using the colors. Little more color you take and your painting is spoiled. So just give few shapes of leaves randomly. We don't want to show too much of leaves. So we are just giving little So now the second painting is also ready, okay? Very good. That's looking wonderful. That's very nice, okay? So now what we will be, just finish it, then we'll make one more painting. Okay, so you all are doing so well, so we'll be going for one more. I hope you all are enjoying. Very good. It's looking beautiful, bachas. So good. So my children are doing so well. Very good. Wonderful job. That's good. Perfect, beta. Perfect. So you want to do one more? Okay. So we'll take, now what we will make? We will make this type of insect, okay? So can you see this? That's very good. Okay? So now you can take one small stone. Because you don't want to make a big insect, so you can take a small one. Yes, just go for the small one. So all ready? So should I start here, everyone? Okay, so take the red color and your thick brush. So just get ready with the black color, thick brush and red color. So just be careful, your brush should be clean. Again, I'm repeating. Otherwise, your red color will become black or blue. So just get ready, clean your brush properly, dry it properly, and then get ready with the red color. See, I have taken a small stone now. We have done two sceneries of big color. And now I'll be going for small one, okay? So I'm just getting ready with the red color. So just take the red color. Okay, now just color full red. See, in this we did for a blue color now. Like that you have to do the red color. So just do complete red color on this stone. Those who are having small stone, just don't worry. Your insect will look beautiful even if the stone is small. Just do the color nicely. We want two or three coatings. We want the red color to be very, very nice on the stone. We don't want to see the stone from the background. So do it thoroughly, okay? If you find it is thin, just give a second coat. So just do the red color on your stone. Good job. Okay. Very good. Very good. So children, I repeat, don't take too much of water. We want the color to dry fast. That's why just take thick color and let the color get dried up. Very good. Very good. So once you have done the red color, just get ready with the thin brush now. When you finish the red color with the thick brush, now we want thin brush. So wash your brush properly, okay? And just get ready with the thin brush now. And the black color. We need a black color and a thin brush. So all ready? Should I proceed, dear? Okay. So now with the help of your thin brush, take little black color and your chalk, make a little curve like this. Like this. Okay. And when you make this curve, now just do it full black. From the top portion. So just give a curve on the top and cover it with the black color. All have done? So good, so good. Yes. You all have become so smart. You are doing so nicely. Very good. Okay. Just do the black color on the top with a little curve. Okay. Yes. I can see you all are doing it nicely. Very good. Just do it. Very good. Very good. Okay. After that, what we will do, I'll show you. Just make a standing line like this. Like this. Okay. Just make a line, straight line with the help of your brush in the middle of the stone. Just make a standing line like this. In the middle of the stone you have to make, okay? These stones look very beautiful on your study table when you use it as a paperweight. They do wonderful job on the table. So what we did, we made a front part little curved with black and then a straight line little thick with the black color. Okay. So now once you have done, just take a earbud in your hands. Last earbud now. And what we will do, okay, finish till here, then I'll do it. Okay, all ready? So just take the earbud. Dip it in the color, little again, just take little color and make few drops on the body of the insect you are making. We are making the bug. See, like this. Okay. Just with the help of your buds. So few drops on both the sides. Just put few drops, dear. Slowly, slowly with less color, then it will look beautiful. Okay? And now the last effect, we want to give, make the eyes of the insect, na? So take the other part of the earbud and take white color and make two eyes with the help of your earbud, right? Like this. So now just look at this. The insect is so beautiful it is looking. Isn't it? Yes, with white color, just dip your earbud in the white color. Take very little color, okay? You don't want too much color because the stone is small. And the insect we are making is so small, so we want a little small drop. So just be careful while taking the color. Very good. Good, good, good. So dip it in the white color and make the eyes, okay? And the black color you're having, so you can just give a small effect of black in the eyes, okay? So the eyes are ready. So we made three paintings today. See, like this. This is the sunset scenery. This is the flower bed. And this is one insect, isn't it? So I hope children, you all liked it. Very good. So those who have finished, just show me on the screen. I would definitely love to see all your paintings. Very good. Oh God, so wonderful. It's looking beautiful, beta. Wonderful. I would love to see your paintings. So nice. Oh God, so good. It's looking so beautiful, bachas. That's beautiful. Very good, darling. So I hope, children, you all had a nice time. Okay, okay. So like this, now you can make many more things with the stone, yes. So when you have a round stone, a flat stone, you can do a wonderful painting on it, isn't it? That's very nice, very nice. So I hope you all had a nice time. Very good. I can see you all have made a wonderful job. Good, good, good. Beautiful. It is looking so beautiful. So I'm so happy to look at your painting. Oh God, so good. That's very nice, bachas. So, good, good, good. So it's time to say bye now. I hope you all had a beautiful time. Oh, good, good, good. So have a nice time. Okay, do post your painting photos on Facebook and Instagram, okay? Okay, so we'll be meeting in some other session with more new things. So have a nice time. Till then, have bye. Okay.